What's up, everyone? The Euros 2024 have finally started, and we have to talk about the TV graphics. In my opinion, they are pretty good. They are doing some pretty interesting stuff with it. And because of this, I want to recreate this scene in Remotion. We are going to animate the formation animation of Team Switzerland, the team that I support. The good news is we have already bagged the first 3 points. The bad news is that I recently ruined my shirt by washing it at 40 degrees. Oh well. This is the animation that I'm going to teach you how to do in Remotion. I think I recreated it pretty well. Also, it is going to be a reverse tutorial. We are going to start from the finished product and we are going to deconstruct it. I think this is going to be more educational. Let me know if you agree. This overlay with the team information is pretty much just a fade animation and not really that interesting at all. So I would say we just remove it and focus on the hard stuff. The same goes for the background image, which is just a regular image tag. And that leaves us with this animation, which is the hard part. Let's work further backwards. I noticed on TV that the whole graphic has a perspective transform applied to it, and it looks like we are looking at it from the top. Because of this, I've also wrapped my whole markup in this perspective transform and have applied a 20 degree rotation to it. If we remove it, it looks like we look at the disk straight. Also, this disc is a bit wider than it is tall, and I have just achieved this by applying a 1.5x horizontal transform. I can remove that, and I can also remove the minus 50% Y translation, and that leaves us with a perfectly centered circle. I have also wrapped the whole scene in a very simple scale animation that just goes from 0 to 1 essentially. We can also remove that to reveal what's underneath. Just a circle with these stripes animating out. We now have two effects that layer on top of each other. In the background, we have a blue circle where only the lower portion of it is animating out. And in the foreground, we have these colorful stripes, which become shorter and shorter, and they are only placed in the lower part of the scene. Let's for now focus only on the colorful stripes, and I'm going to remove one effect after another until we only have a very simple and easy to understand animation left. Each one of the stripes are randomized with a delay, and we can just set that delay to 0. Now they all have the same timing. And we also have an initial progress between 0 and 0.3. I'm just going to set it to the same for every stripe. Each stripe is being rendered with this ray component. And what we do in here is we first create an SVG circle using the Remotion shapes library. And then we cut the path to only take 1/66th of the circle, because I have defined in my other file that the circle has 66 segments. This is just an arbitrary number that I thought would make the animation look good. I use new array to create an array with many rays, and here I have decided to render only 1/3 of the stripes that would make a full circle. And for each stripe, I have most importantly assigned a rotation. This rotation consists of multiple components. First of all, I have added this offset. Without it, it would have started at the top by default. And with this code, I've essentially made it so that the segments, if they are all rendered, would form a circle. If I remove this rotation, then each stripe would be at the same position. Let's for now only render one single segment and find out how we can achieve this type of animation. As I've mentioned previously, this is just a circle that I have cut using the cut path Remotion paths helper function. What if I were to not cut the path? We would see the full circle, and if we move forward the animation, we can see that it is just a circle with a really bold stroke that gets thinner over time. By default, an SVG path has its stroke in the middle of the line, but I find it easier to do the math if we use an inner stroke instead of a center stroke. And I have achieved this by subtracting half of the stroke width from the radius. If I remove that, the whole thing is going to look a bit different. We animate the stroke width of the circle to initially be as wide as the entire radius of the circle. This will make it appear as it is a fully filled circle, even though it is only a stroked one, technically. If we remove that and only set the end value, which is just an arbitrary small number, then only this animation is remaining. And you can see what we are animating. We are just making the radius bigger over time. As for the background circle, we are doing the exact same thing, except we are rendering all 66 segments, and we are saying that the initial radius is for 2/3 of the segments, so the ones here at the top already the full radius, so that they become static and don't animate at all. Otherwise, exact same technique. I drive all animations using springs, and since I haven't mentioned this in any previous tutorial yet, I should mention that as of the latest Remotion version, we have made them a lot easier by now supporting a delay parameter, by supporting the from and to parameters, by supporting the duration in frames parameter if you like to use it. We have also launched the spring animation editor where you can play around with the values and see how the springs will animate. And also one thing I like to do is to curry the spring functions. So here I have a progress function which based on some parameters just returns a spring value, and with that I can have each one of the segments have the same animation curve, but randomize the delay and the initial value a bit. I find that very helpful. So in order to create this animation, essentially do all of the steps in reverse order. Let me know what you think of this tutorial style. It is of course not a step-by-step tutorial, but I think it is easier to get some takeaways from it rather than if I typed out everything line by line and you had to watch me for an hour or so. Also, which team do you support at the Euros? If you have watched so far, then spam some country flags into the comments. I appreciate you watching the video and see you soon.